Indigenous leaders are fed up with Australian politics and politicians and are demanding the government support bilingual education.
When governments attempt to manipulate and dictate our lives, such as threatening to send all our teenagers away from our communities, or telling us that we can't teach our children how to read and write in their own language, we feel like a knife has gone through our body and the knife keeps going deeper and deeper.
I say stop that. English is not the first language of this country. It is the many Aboriginal nations.
Indigenous students comprise just 4.8% of all school students. And now the government wants to force secondary students from remote territory communities into boarding schools away from home.
We also object to the recommendation that all our secondary students should be sent away to boarding school. Boarding school should be a choice that family makes, as some already do. However, if this recommendation is implemented, and we have been told it will, our communities will not have choice.
Yalmay Yunupingu works at the only bilingual school in Yirrkala in eastern Arnhem Land, where English is taught as a second language. Her concerns are supported by the daughter of land rights activist Eddie Mabo. Gail Mabo said her father also fought for an education system that acknowledged First Nations people.
He opened his own school. And through this school, he actually advocated that the language of Meriam was spoken at the school. That was the first, most important language at the school. English was the second. And he opened the first black community school in Australia, in Townsville.
Cape York Indigenous leader Noel Pearson is currently working to develop a literacy and numeracy model for remote schools in the Northern Territory, but Yalmay Yunupingu says her community has not been consulted. Central Australian elder and human rights campaigner Rosalie Kunoth-Monks fears our younger generations will be deprived of their heritage if the government ignores her plea for consultation.
I do not want my grandchild being one-dimensional, assimilated to hell, and a carbon copy of the settlers that came later on. That child is a heritage that is well over 40,000 years, and it's a glorious heritage. Let's hold it and let's be strong. Long may the Aboriginal nations of Australia continue.
Tariq Allen in NITV News.